Hi, today's topic is the Millennium Mindset Part 4. Today I want to share what really separates the rich people from the poor. In fact, everybody has got the same time, everybody has got the same opportunities. But why is that some people are taking an advantage and they are becoming rich and some people are not able to be there? What is the difference? So what is that separates rich people from the poor people? As I always keep saying, it's purely the mindset. So here, which I want to share to you today is on leveraging. As I keep saying, everybody has got 24 hours. So in 24 hours, what is that we can do? Or how the rich people do it differently in this 24 hours? This is where I want to share. And this is a very interesting topic which I share. And in fact, I've shared this many in my training programs. And this is the first time I'm going to share on the video is on leveraging. I'll just give a simple example on leveraging. Okay? So in fact, when you're talking about leveraging, what exactly is leveraging? Leveraging is doing or getting more results with less effort. Getting more returns with less effort. That's leveraging. In fact, I saw some laborers actually, the way they were moving a piece of stone. Okay, so it's a very huge stone. And it was very difficult for a single person to move the stone. But what I saw was through a crowbar, okay, there's through the crowbar, they were moving it very easily. And I was just wondering, wow, this is leveraging. The same leveraging is being used by the rich people, not the crowbars, with the way of their thinking. First one which I want to share here is other people's time. The first thing which they use on leveraging on other people's time. As I keep saying, like everybody has got 24 hours. In 24 hours, like for example, if I am working, maximum I can work for 8 to 10 hours. But if I have some 10 people with me, okay, and who are also putting close to 10 hours, my working hours in a day is 100 hours. If I have 100 people working for 10 hours a day, what is my working hours? I can just multiply it like that. So the first thing what people really understand, the rich people really understand is, they have to have more number of people so that their times can be added to their working hours. So this is how the first formula, the first thing they use is leveraging on others people's time. The second one they use is on leveraging on others people's knowledge. In fact, I always keep saying people is, you know, everybody is not competent enough with on everything, or they are not master of all the subjects or all the areas. So other people's knowledge. As I keep saying, rich people know how to leverage on other people's knowledge. For example, you want a chartered accountant. You can, many people try to do their accountancy, or they try to do, accounts work on their own. But the rich people know how to leverage on this kind of people. They hire the experts, they pay them for the services, and they get the things done. And in fact, I always keep saying, like, you know, I was into computer field. In fact, I was into technical field. In fact, I was more into hardware and assembling and repairing also. But today, if my own computer gets crashed, I don't repair it. Why? Because I know my time is not equal to that, or my value is not equal to that. What a person is working. So I, instead of doing on my own, I hire a person and get my things done. Again, leveraging on other people's knowledge. In fact, I always keep saying is, if you see most of the successful people, they always hire the best consultants, the best coaches. Why? They know that's the best way to leverage, and that's how they can move faster in life. But there are other set of people, I'm talking about other category of people, they try to do everything on their own. This is where the problem, and this is where they stay poor. Next one, other people's money, OPM, other people's money. Again, the rich people don't invest their money in business or anything, okay? They try to invest the bank's money or try to invest other people's money for making money. In fact, I was just sharing to one person and teaching him how without money he can do business. Interested? I just have one tip. Let me share the same tip to you. So I was saying that real estate is one of the areas. Real estate is one of the areas where you don't require to invest any money at all. You're shocked. Yes, I said, okay, you can just find out a person who's having some land, talk to him, have some contract with him, and start to sell the property without even giving 1 rupee to the landowner, and without spending any money, you can also be a part of that business. And there are some strategies which I'll be teaching only when a person comes to my program. Okay, so here what I show to people is you can start making money without even investing money, and this is where the rich people are doing. And if you can go back and see, most of the builders, they try to use this formula without investing their money. They invest others' money to make money. And the last one which I want to share with you here is other people's contacts or other people's relations. In fact, one of the favorite quote by Robert Kiyosaki is, rich people network and others work. Why? I don't have a huge network, but I can find out the people who are having a network. Okay. And if at all I want to connect to a person, I need to find out the person who is connected with this person. So when I connected to that particular person, I get a huge network. So similarly, this is where the rich people try to tap into the networks. So through that, they expand the network. Through one person, a few people, they expand the network. And what actually happens is the network expands. And again, rich people are more concerned about the people. It's a people's business. But I always keep saying, when you really do what people are looking for, you automatically become rich. But when you're just running behind money on a selfish motive, you never become rich. So whatever you're trying to do, always see in what way this can benefit people. You will really be there. And the last one which I want to share to you is, rich people always work on the trends, or they tap the technology, they take the advantage of the technology. So today's technology is on social media. So today's technology is how do I include my business with the technology? How do I upgrade myself with the technology? And we have to keep on learning with the technology, because I always keep saying, if you're not with the technology, you're outdated. You're out of the business. And again, all which I want to share to people is, with all these business tips and business knowledges, I as a coach on law of attraction, as a mind power coach, I combine both of this and program the person's and the subconscious level. And what I try to do is, we do it online. As I keep saying, we do it online, and any part of the world, we make a difference in your life through this online programs. The beauty which I always keep saying here is, instead of you running behind all the things starts running behind you. Let it be the people, let it be the contacts, let it be the relationship, let it be the money, let it be a business. Yes. And in fact, I heard many calls and many business people telling me that, I've been having a lot of financial problems, I've been doing great loss, and I'm not able to pay my bills, and I don't know why I'm stuck in this area. And for those people, I want to say only one thing is, you need to change your energy. Okay? And that's what this entire program is. How do I change my energy? So if you're keen to know more about what is this energy changing, and what is the law of attraction, and what is that coaching program which I do, please get into my website, and my numbers are flashing here. You can also call me and book an appointment, and I'll be there to help you out. Again, if you're new to my Facebook, please subscribe to my Facebook, please be a part of my Facebook Live, and also please be a part of my YouTube channels, subscribe to YouTube channels, and regularly get the updates. And as I keep saying, these are only some tips which I'm trying to share. There are lots and lots which I'll be sharing on a day-to-day basis. So be a part of it, and also keep sharing this video to as many people as you can. Again, Wilfred Stanley signing off from Rapid Mind Power. Bye. Thank you. Have a great day.